Hey there, I have an awesome lesson for you today, because today I am showing you how to solve systems of equations using the substitution method. Today's lesson is part two in a three-part series on solving systems of equations. So if you are brand new to systems of equations, I recommend you go watch part one first, where I introduce what systems of equations are. And if you've already watched that, you're ready for part two, where we solve them using the substitution method. Let's get started. Whenever you are given a system of equations and asked to solve, what that really means is that you have two or more equations and you need to find the intersection point or points. Now, the most common case you're going to run into is being given two linear equations and looking for their intersection point. Now, there are three possible scenarios you can have with a system of linear equations. Most often, they're going to intersect in one point, although if they are parallel lines, they will never intersect. And if they are really the same line, then they are going to intersect in infinitely many points. If you'd like a recap of those scenarios and exactly what that looks like, check out my tutorial on systems of equations, the graphing method. So today we are looking at the substitution method, and in that method we want to isolate a variable in one of these equations and then substitute that relationship into the other equation. To begin with, you always want to scan your equations and see if there's any nice variables to work with. So if you see a variable that doesn't have a number coefficient written in front, it is most likely the easiest variable to isolate. So in problem number one here, we have 2x plus y equals 1 and 3x plus 4y equals 14. I notice immediately that the y in the first equation doesn't have a coefficient written in front of it, so that is the variable I want to isolate. After solving for y, I get y equals 1 minus 2x. And now what I want to do here is take this relationship and substitute it in for y in the other equation. What that will give me is an equation that only has x variables, and once I have an equation with one variable, I can solve for that variable. So here I have replaced y in this equation with what y is equivalent to, which is 1 minus 2x, and now I have an equation with only x's in, and my next step here is to solve for x. So I'm going to begin by distributing 4 through, and then combining like terms and solving. Now that I know what x is, I can go ahead and plug it back into this equation here to find y. Now we have discovered the x and y coordinate where these two lines intersect, and I'm just going to write my final answer as a coordinate point. In this second problem, I have negative 7x minus 2y equals negative 13, and x minus 2y equals 11. So if I'm going to use the substitution method, the easiest variable to isolate in this problem will be this x in the second equation. So my first step is to take this second equation and rearrange it so x is alone. Now that I have what x is equivalent to, I can go ahead and plug it in for x in the other equation. So here I just replaced x with my equivalent relation, which is 2y plus 11. And notice here how when I substituted this relationship in for x, I made sure to put parentheses. And that's a really important step because that ensures that this negative 7 is going to be distributed to both terms. Next, I am going to distribute the negative 7 through, combine like terms, and solve for y. So here I get y equals negative 4, and once again, my last step is to take that negative 4 and plug it back in for y. The easiest place to plug it in is the relationship we have here, where x is isolated. So I'm going to replace y in the 2y plus 11 with negative 4. Okay, now I have my xy coordinate pair, and of course the last step is to write that as an xy coordinate. So the place where these two lines intersect is at the coordinate point 3, negative 4. So in this final problem, we are going to approach it just like we did in the last two problems. Now the only difference between this problem and the previous problems is that the numbers aren't quite as friendly. There is no variable that is lacking a coefficient like we had in the first two examples, so I'm just going to pick whichever variable I want to solve for, and I'm going to make my decision based off of what looks like it will be the easiest. So in equation 1, they are all multiples of 2, so I think that those numbers will reduce a little bit easier than having numbers that aren't so compatible, like in the second equation, and I'm just going to do that just because I want to avoid any fractions. Sometimes it's unavoidable, but here I think we can get around it. So I'm going to take the first equation, and I could solve for either x or y, and I think I'm going to solve for x. Okay, there I have found my relationship. Now that I know that x is equivalent to 3y minus 3, I'm going to go ahead and replace x in the other equation with 3y minus 3. I have found that y equals 2, and once again, my final step is to take that value and plug it into this equation for y. And now that I know what x and y is, I'm just going to write the coordinate point. Next time on Math Hacks, I'm going to show you how to use the elimination method to solve systems of equations. So you're going to want to make sure to subscribe to the channel to get updates on that. And why don't you increase your math karma today by giving this video a big thumbs up to recommend. Till next time, I'm Brett, and thank you so much for joining me.